Candlelight Music presents for the first time the million-dollar magic of Fats Domino.
I want to walk you home.
Discover more gold records than you've ever dreamed of.
Yes, it's me and I'm in love again, Saturday morning.
The million-dollar magic of Fats Domino is a golden treasury.
I like the way you walk.
Wonderful memory.
I like the way you talk. 3 nights a week.
Yeah.
You're gone from here. Kiss me. Kiss you, I love. Hey, Dad. I'm gonna be a wheel someday. This time I'm walking to New Orleans. When my dream comes,
precious memories.
Run home, you win again. Oh, Weaver, oh, Weaver. You know I love you. Yes, I do. And I'm saving all my loving
angel for you.
I hear you knocking. Come on, baby, and be my guest.
In the valley of tears.
Be happy, my dear.
Found my thrill.
The million-dollar magic of Fats Domino in a big album collection is only $6.98. Total tape treasury only $9.98. This exclusive is not sold in any store at any price.
On Blueberry Hill.
I got a whole lot of love for you.
Blue Monday.
For your special Candlelite treasury, you must act now.
I'm walking. Yes, indeed.
To order, call toll-free 1-800-228-3300, 1-800-228-3300. Save COD, send $6.98 for record, $9.98 for tape to Fats Domino, Arlington Answering Service, 702 A East Abram, Arlington, Texas. That's Fats Domino, Arlington Answering Service, 702 A East Abram, Arlington, or call 1-800-228-3300.
For the best bubble buys in town, come to Sigel's. Try this sparkling gem from Italy, Gancia Spumonti, with its unique, deliciously light sweetness. Ruby red or white, special $2.99 at Sigel's. Or celebrate with Fontaine, a good California champagne, a true champagne, naturally fermented in the bottle. Your choice, pink, extra dry, or cold duck, two bottles, $6. Now at Sigel's, Dallas' number one wine merchant.
October 5th, 9 p.m. Memo from Frank Lucas, license appraiser, to John Benjamin, attorney. Subject, inventory, the state of Hiram Drake, deceased. Okay, John, you wanted this appraisal completed by Friday. So I came back tonight, but if you expect me to be working evenings, you better have the power turned back on. This place gives me the shivers. Quite a character you're, Mr. Drake. Just the type who would go for concealed panels and hidden staircases. Now, I've completed the inventory of the first and second floors, and now I'm ready to tackle that secret collection you said he spent so much money on.
in the cellar now. Fantastic. This place is really like a tomb and a pyramid. I couldn't possibly estimate the value of all this stuff. It would take an expert in Egyptology to do that. Well, you know that mummy case you said arrived just before he died? You never looked inside, did you? Well, there's something in there. I want to get a full description on tape right away for the insurance company. There's a mummy with a gold amulet around its neck, with the face of a cat and emeralds for eyes. You wouldn't believe it unless you saw it with your own eyes.
Something I can do for you?
You have some unusual jewelry here.
It's all for sale.
Ever buy any?
That depends.
Candlesticks, old pewter, silverware, jewelry?
How did you happen to come here?
I heard you were interested in stuff like that.
You were misinformed. It's late. We're getting ready to close.
Give me a minute. There's something I'd like to show you. Here.
Where did this come from?
It's a family heirloom. My grandmother died.
Sorry about that.
Look at the workmanship. A valuable antique.
Solid gold.
Those jeweled eyes.
Emeralds.
Well?
Get out.
You can have it for a good price.
I wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole.
Wait a minute.
Just exactly 1 minute. If you're not out of here by then, you heard me. Out! One minute. Day's over.
You're right. And I'm going home.
Well, what's the rush? Aren't we going out for a bite to eat?
I'm tired.
I presume you have a date tonight.
No. And I don't have any bread either. In case you forgot, it's payday.
Oh, but of course.
Thank you. Hey, where did this come from?
Do you like it?
Yeah. I've been looking for something to carry my things around with me when I go sketching.
Well, it's yours. A present for me.
Hey, super. Thanks, Esther.
Enjoy.
Sherry.
Want a ride home?
I'd rather walk.
You really shouldn't be walking alone this time of night.
Don't worry. Three blocks won't kill me.
Over garbage cans. Hey, you hungry?
Oh, I get the message.
Come on. Come on.
And make yourself at home. Hey, peace, baby. Give me a chance to stash my loot. Two more weeks, kitty. And I'll have enough saved to buy some wheels and cut out of here. I'm fed up with Miss Hester. The way she acts, she thinks she owns me. Hey, kitty. I'll go see if we have some caviar in the refrigerator. Sorry, fresh out of caviar. You'll just have to settle for milk. You're a champagne freak. Hey, what's that on your fur? Looks like blood.
You know, next to losing a loved one, separation and divorce are the most difficult emotional times people experience. And the legal problems only make it more difficult. I'm Wallace Craig. If you're having domestic problems and need to know how divorce laws affect you, your property, and your children, we'd like to help you. Call my office and let's arrange an appointment. There's no charge for your first visit.
In their own world of darkness, they gather. Drawn by the scent of the living, they prepare for a night of unearthly horror. Now showing at a theater near you.
For the best bubble buys in town, come to Majestic. Try this sparkling gem from Italy. Gancia Spumonti with its unique, deliciously light sweetness. Ruby red or white, special $2.99 at Majestic. Or celebrate with Fontaine. A good California champagne, a true champagne. Naturally fermented in the bottle. Your choice, pink, extra dry, or cold duck. Two bottles, $6. Now at Majestic, Fort Worth's number one wine merchant.
Okay, sleepyhead, let's put you in a fresh Pampers and off to Nappyland.
Pampers?
My grandmother says good mothers use cloth diapers.
Carol, I'm a good mother and I use quilted Pampers.
Because they stay twice as dry as cloth.
Gee, it is quilted.
Twice as dry? Wet both and wait a minute. Quilted Pampers stay twice as dry.
And dryers gotta feel better. Especially when she's sleeping.
Quilted Pampers stay twice as dry.
I'm looking for a sales clerk. I'm afraid I find myself short-handed. Are you interested, Miss...
Carter. Rena Carter.
I'm Hester Black. Sounds like a witch, doesn't it? But my customers seem to like it. Most of them are into witchcraft, black magic, Satanism.
Well, I'm afraid I really don't know very much about that sort of thing.
Oh, no problem, my dear. Once you learn the stock, it'll be just like working in a delicatessen, without having to smell the garlic. Well?
Well, I do need a job. If you really think I can handle it.
I'm sure you can.
Told to see a Lieutenant Marco here.
Try the patio. Upstairs through the living room.
Right, thank you.
The case you said arrived just before he died. You never looked inside, did you? Well, there's something in there. I want to get a full description on tape right away for the insurance company. There's a mummy.
What do you want?
Well, you call the university and you ask them to send somebody over.
That's right. With
the face. Well, here I am. My name's Roger Edmonds.
Are you a professor?
That's right.
But I wasn't sure whether you guys moonlighted on the job.
You don't know much about teacher salaries, do you, Lieutenant? I teach a course in archaeology.
I asked the school to send over an expert on Egypt.
Well, I'm afraid I'm all that was available. I'm not a specialist, but I do have a great interest in Egyptology.
Egyptology, huh? Yeah, well, you know what happened here last night?
I was told the man was killed, but I don't get the connection. What do you want from me?
I'm going to play a tape for you. And then I want to show you something downstairs. Well, you fellas could read these inscriptions.
It's not that simple. And besides, most of these have been defaced. It could be that somebody didn't want this mummy identified.
We found a chisel right here. The lab is running a check for fingerprints.
I don't think this was done by a chisel. For instance, look. See these parallel scratches? They look more like claw marks to me.
Well, since when are you a detective?
No, I'm not. But archaeology depends a great deal on detection. And besides, Agatha Christie's my favorite writer. Now tell me, how did the appraiser die?
Ask Agatha Christie.
Well, you did mention the wounds on his throat. Couldn't those have been made by some sort of animal?
There's an autopsy going on right now. The mummy and the amulet are missing. You want to try to tell me that an animal stole them?
Oh, no.
Yeah. Now, there's pewter and silverware pieces missing from upstairs, too. And that was a thief. When he opened the mummy's case, he found the amulet. And then he unwrapped the mummy, searching for more jewelry. When the air hit the mummy, it crumpled.
Then shouldn't we see the dust of bone fragments, or...
What is it?
A symbol. A symbol of Bast.
Bast?
The great cat-headed goddess of Lower Egypt.
Cat goddess?
Oh, yes. The cult of Bast flourished for centuries. Then around 400 B.C., it was stamped out. Its priests were hunted down and buried alive.
Why?
Well, mainly because they believed that in return for human sacrifices, the goddess could grant them eternal life. And they were also supposed to have the power to turn into cats.
What are you trying to make of all this?
Just giving you the historical facts, Lieutenant.
Well, here's something for you to think about. Now, whoever committed the murder was after the amulet. Stealing of the mummy was part of his cover-up.
What about the strange marks on the appraiser's face?
Any number of weapons could have caused those wounds.
This just came in from the coroner's office.
Bad news.
They finished the preliminary examination of the corpse. The wounds on the throat were made by teeth and claws. There were cat hairs on the body.
Good afternoon. Yes, just a moment, please.
Who is it?
Some man is looking for someone named Sherry.
I'll take it. Yes? Miss Black speaking? That's right. No, I couldn't say. Sorry.
Who's this Sherry he's looking for?
Oh... Just a girl who used to work for me before you came.
You getting tired, Professor?
I never knew this town had so many pawn shops.
Oh, relax. This is just the beginning.
Why do you think the killer would want to pawn that amulet?
Well, why not? He's got it up at some place, doesn't he?
Suppose he didn't try to sell. Maybe he's a collector himself.
No way. If he was a collector, he'd take all the Egyptian stuff he could get his hands on. All he took from upstairs was silver. He could unload that anywhere. All he took from downstairs was the amulet. That's solid gold. Listen, why don't you quit being the detective, huh? All I want from you is identification when we find the piece.
If we find it.
One more stop and we'll call it a day.
Well, why are we stopping here?
You'll see.
Face of a cat? It's the only cat we've got.
No, that doesn't even look like it. No, it's an amulet. Now, you're sure nobody stopped by in the last couple of days with anything like it?
Well, I wouldn't know. I just started working here yesterday.
Maybe somebody else saw it. What about your boss?
What's all this? Lieutenant.
Miss Black. Want you to meet a friend of mine, Roger Edmonds. Hester Black. One of the sharpest fences in the business.
Now, really, Marco. You know that's all over and done with. I'm straight.
Straight? Well, you could sleep on a corkscrew.
Look, if you came here to insult me...
No, I just want to ask you a few questions.
It was something about an amulet with the face of a cat. I tried to tell them I've never seen it.
Well, that's true, Lieutenant, but I did.
When?
3 nights ago. This man came in here with a story about a family heirloom. The story was phony, but the piece was genuine. It was about 3 inches wide, solid gold, emerald eyes, big stones, exquisite work.
What'd you pay for it?
Are you out of your mind? I told him to get out.
Can you describe this man?
Middle-aged, Oriental, Chinese, I'd say.
Anyone else in the store here?
No, just a clerk. But she was in the back room.
Her?
No, the girl before her.
Who? What's her name?
Hastings. Sherry Hastings.
That's odd. I got a routine report on a Sherry Hastings yesterday from the coroner's office.
The girl who used to work here is dead?
Suicide. She did a header off her balcony of her apartment 3 nights ago.
Oh. Why didn't you tell me about the last girl?
I intended to, but I was so terribly upset.
And why did she kill herself?
I don't know. She seemed perfectly all right when she left here.
There has to be a reason. You know, when you were describing that amulet, I got the feeling as though I could see it. A golden cat, thousands of years old. You know what they say about the ancient Egyptians guarding their dead? Suppose that amulet had some kind of curse on it?
Oh, look, it's only a piece of jewelry, and Sherry never even saw it.
You sure it's not here?
Believe me, the amulet is not here.
Okay. Get some rest now. I'll see you in the morning. Perhaps dinner tomorrow night.
Perhaps.
Hi. Roger Edmonds, remember me? Oh, hardly. Only a poor university instructor. Lieutenant Marco asked me to help him with his case.
Did he ask you to follow me, too?
Oh, no. Coming back here was my own idea. You just seemed so upset, I just wanted to make sure you were all right, that's all.
Thank you. You don't have to worry.
Oh, worrying's my hobby. Teaching archaeology and Egyptology is just a job.
Egyptology?
Huh? The lieutenant wants me to help him decipher and identify the stolen amulet, if we ever find it.
Do you think he can?
You know what? That's a very complicated question. Now, I'll tell you what. Suppose I try answering it while we're having dinner. What do you say?
All right, thank you.
Great. Come on. And by then, you see, the Shoshank, or Libyan pharaohs, believe that Bast was the daughter of Ra, the sun god. And for her shrine, they built a great city called Bubastis, the House of Bast.
You know, you really do sound like a professor.
Meaning I don't know when to shut up. Okay, it's your turn. You tell me all about yourself.
What do you want to know?
Everything.
Now you sound like a detective.
Lieutenant Marco's a good teacher.
Well, let's see how good you are. What do you know about me?
Well, you told me you're from the East. You're new in town.
Yeah, what else?
You're quick, intelligent, and you're a loner.
Now, why do you say that?
Well, a teacher tends to analyze his students. You're the quiet type. You want to relate to people, but actually are shy, right? And that's very surprising, because you're warm, you're charming, and you're beautiful.
Now, wait a minute. I never told you that.
You didn't need to.
Oh, God. A good meal, a little flattery, ever heard. Oh, Roger, it's such a glorious evening. dance and just dance on the street.
All this on just two Mai Tais.
Yeah.
What's the matter? Just a pet shop.
It scares me.
Why?
I don't know. I don't know. Let's just go.
If you're worried about the high cost of dental work, these phone numbers could save you money. I'm Dennis Barron of Denture Centers of America. Our dentures and removable bridge work are made of materials approved by the American Dental Association, fitted by licensed, experienced dentists, and save you $100 to $500 or more. Let Denture Centers of America help you. Call now. Offices in Dallas, 823-2981, and Fort Worth, 263-2473.
No credit needed. We finance. Drive home in your own car, starting as little as $150 down. Credit Motors, 2208 East Lancaster, Fort Worth. No credit needed. We finance. Drive home in your own car, starting as little as $150 down. Continental Motors, 2801 East Lancaster, Fort Worth. No credit needed. We finance. Drive home in your own car, starting as little as $150 down. Lynn Smith Auto Sales, 2900 East Lancaster, Fort Worth.
ABC TV Rental gets together with Zenith for an exciting home entertainment package. Now you can rent this bookcase wall unit with famous Zenith Chromacolor TV, hi-fi receiver with 8-track tape, separate turntable, and Zenith Allegro speakers. ABC TV Rental puts it all together, and when you rent from ABC, there are no repair bills and no obligation. Call ABC today and have this Zenith Home Entertainment Center in your home tonight.
When I have a cold, I don't care how I get my vitamin C, but I won't have a cold without Puffs.
I can live without my hot water bottle, but I won't have a cold without Puffs.
There's just no substitute for Puffs when sneezing and blowing can mean a sore nose, because Puffs are softer, less irritating than any tissue. Prove it to yourself. Compare Puffs with any brand.
Puffs are softer.
So don't have a cold without Puffs.
Oh, good afternoon.
It was, until now.
Well, this will only take a moment. Got something I want to show you. After that description you gave me yesterday afternoon, I pulled a few mug shots out of the file. Mm. Maybe you'll recognize one of them.
Yeah. No. Sorry. Sorry. That's your man.
Are you sure that's him?
Positive.
Yeah.
Who is he?
Well, that's Joe Sung. Part-time handyman, full-time wino. Three counts of breaking and entry. Last month, he was a gardener at the Drake Estate.
Then he knew the place. How to get in. Why would he kill that appraiser?
He'll explain that when we find him.
Where do you look?
Where do you look for a wino in this town?
Yeah, I know the party. Joe Sung.
You sure it's the same guy?
Yeah. Signed the register. See? Joe Sung, room 206.
Hi, big boy. You want a drink?
Be quiet, Maybelle.
When's the date of this entry?
I guess I goofed. You know how it is, officer. A fella gets busy.
When did he check in?
Let me see now. Last night, maybe 10:30, 11.
Oh, yeah, I saw the guy.
Any luggage?
Carrying a load, if that's what you mean.
Is he up in his room now?
Is he dead?
Looking for Miss Carter.
It's her day off.
Oh, good. I was afraid she might have been upset by the news.
News?
The man who tried to sell you that amulet. He was killed last night. Didn't you see the paper?
I don't read newspapers.
But you do read tarot cards.
Why not? Magic is my business.
Rena said you didn't believe in such things.
When did she tell you that?
Night before last, we had dinner together.
I see.
Well, maybe I can find her at home this afternoon. Don't let me interrupt your game.
It's not a game, Mr. Edwards. As an Egyptologist, you certainly know that the tarot cards represent pages from the ancient Egyptian Book of Thoth, and that for centuries, men have used its symbols to look into the mysterious future.
I know, just as they use all the other stuff you sell here. Crystal balls, I Ching, palmistry charts. It is all fortune-telling, you know.
Suppose I were to tell you that when I spread out the tarot cards last night, it foretold the death of Joe Sung.
Then why didn't you warn Lieutenant Marco?
Because he would have laughed at me as you do now.
I'm not laughing at you. But there is such a thing as coincidence. You can't ignore it.
There is such a thing as fate, and you can't escape it. Suppose I were to tell you that I am spreading these 10 cards for you, Mr. Edmonds.
Now, why this sudden interest in me?
Because of your sudden interest in matters that shouldn't normally concern you. The amulet, the murders. You are part of the pattern now.
What pattern?
Well, see for yourself. Here you are in your present position.
The fool.
With the immediate influence over you, the devil.
Are you sure you didn't stack this deck?
Fate guides my hand, Mr. Edmonds. The third card represents your goal, the world. The fourth card, your distant past. The card below, your recent past. And this one, a reference to your future.
The hangman. I'm sorry, I don't believe in capital punishment.
Symbolism. This card represents me, the questioner.
The high priestess.
This one, your environment, symbolized by the tower. And your inner emotion, the magician. This is number 9.
But you said this was a 10-card spread.
The first 9 represent you and the conditions surrounding you. The 10th card will show you the final result you may expect from all this.
Well, don't stop now.
Suppose you deal the card. That is, unless you are afraid.
Why should I be afraid? After all, it's my fate.
Yes, Mr. Edmonds, it is your fate.
Somehow, I never pictured you in a place like this.
I know it, but it's a bargain. The owners are in Europe. They just wanted someone to stay here while they're gone. When I heard the rent, I couldn't resist.
Where did you live before?
In an apartment.
No, I mean before you came to town. What about your family?
I'm on my own. I'm awfully glad you're here.
I was worried about you. Again. Don't you ever get the feeling of being isolated up here?
You forget I'm a loner.
You shouldn't be. You don't have to be.
Hello? Oh, yes, just a moment, please. It's for you.
Hello?
I tried to get you at school, but they told me you already left. So I stopped by the sorcerer's shop. I've got the pawn ticket.
You've got the pawn ticket?
We found it in Joe Sung's left shoe. The poor joker gave away the amulet for drinking money. He never realized how much he could really get for it. Well, the Egyptian government claimed the Drake collection was smuggled in illegally. They're considering a reward for the return of the amulet. $50,000. No questions asked. If they do, I figure you're entitled to a cut for the identification. Now, how about it, Professor? You willing to take a ride with me? It's a Hollywood pawnbroker. Santa Monica and Western. I've got one stop to make on the way. The county morgue. I'll see you there in a half hour.
Thanks.
Oh, Lieutenant. Good luck.
Note the bites and claw marks on the throat. The shape of the lacerations indicate they were inflicted by an animal the size of a domestic cat.
A cat?
If you'll examine the jugular vein.
That's enough.
I merely wanted to point out that these wounds are the same as those we found on the body of the appraiser.
Mm-hmm. So, you think it might be... It might be the same type of animal?
The same animal? The bacterial cultures from the wounds of both victims are identical.
Rabies?
No indication.
Then what you're saying is that these men were killed and attacked by a common domestic cat?
I'm not offering an opinion. My job is to give the evidence.
It didn't make any sense.
One thing more, Lieutenant. The bodies of both victims were almost completely drained of blood.
And after all, you got to realize that the ancient Egyptians weren't just idiots who worshipped gods with the heads of animals. Those heads were only symbols of supernatural forces, like the signs of the zodiac. And the Egyptian priests claimed they could use such forces. Do you understand what I'm saying?
To understand, yes. Believe, no.
And just remember this, Lieutenant. While our ancestors were still living in caves, the Egyptians were building the Great Pyramid. They knew medicine, navigation, astronomy. They held the key to so many things. Secrets that we still haven't learned.
Like cats that drink human blood.
I suppose, now just suppose, and I know this sounds ridiculous, that blood is necessary to preserve immortal life.
Like vampires, huh? Forget it, Professor.
All right, then, what's your theory?
I'll tell you all about it just as soon as I get my hands on that amulet.
Anybody here?
This'll get him to stop squeezing, Charmin.
Charmin's so squeezably soft.
Irresistible.
Do what the sign says.
We are!
Mr. Whipple never learns. Charmin made the ordinary way might not get squeezed. But Charmin's fluffed up with so much squeezable softness, it's irresistible.
Ladies, please.
Do what the sign says, Mr. Whipple.
Friction is here in every engine, robbing power, causing wear. Today's engines need more than oil to fight friction. They need petrol on Slick 50, not an oil or an additive. Slick 50 is a metal protective coating formulated with DuPont Teflon to increase gas mileage and engine performance. The critical parts in your engine can benefit from Slick 50's extended protection. Put Slick 50 with Teflon to work in your engine. It's satisfaction guaranteed.
Sleep Country, Dallas' largest retailer of mattresses, announces a gigantic special factory purchase of discontinued 1979 models. Over 2,000 famous mattress and box springs now sale price just $69.95 each piece for twin, full, queen, and king. Choose from Simmons, Sealy, Restonic, and Spring Air. Choose from Firm, Extra Firm, Posture Firm, and Luxury Firm. Sleep Country, quality merchandise, unbeatable prices. That's what makes us different. On Midway north of LBJ, in Garland at LBJ in Centerville, and Arlington next to Six Flags Mall.
Hi, I'm Clyde Crum, appraisal consultant. I'd like to say hello to all my friends and customers and a happy holiday season from all the appraisal staff.
Miss Carter, I was looking for Hester.
Oh, she hasn't come in yet. You checked her apartment?
You bet we have.
Lieutenant, you don't think she had anything to do with what happened yesterday, do you? Well, why suspect her? Pawn shops are robbed every day.
That's right. But in this case, nothing was touched. The only thing missing was the amulet.
If she wanted that, she could have bought it the night it was stolen.
Well, like she said, too risky.
What reason would she have for changing her mind?
Plenty of reasons. She heard me talk about the reward when I phoned from here yesterday. She got to the shop ahead of me and tried to con the pawnbroker out of the amulet. Only she didn't have a ticket. It was a hassle. She reached for the paper knife off the desk and...
Please, no. Do you think she'll try and claim the reward?
There won't be any. The State Department recommended the Egyptian government to withdraw the reward offer. They felt it would encourage thefts of other relics from all over the world.
It was all for nothing, and Hester's gone.
I don't think so. There's an AP out. Her apartment's staked out. We've got a car in custody. And even if she tries to leave town, it's going to take money. And that's where you come in.
I don't understand.
Hester keeps cash on hand here at the shop, doesn't she?
Yes, some.
Well, she'll probably try to get a hold of it. I want you to keep this place open tonight. Just in case she comes back.
What if she does?
I'll put this place under 24-hour surveillance. You'll be perfectly safe, I guarantee you.
And she agreed?
There's nothing to worry about. She'll be all right. You take my word for it. Hester won't harm her.
I'm not thinking about Hester. All right, maybe she did kill a pawnbroker, but that still doesn't explain what happened to the others.
Well, what do you want me to do? Put out an AP for the mummy of an Egyptian priest and a cat that drinks human blood?
I don't care what you do, but Rena must be protected.
She is. Now, you take my word for it. I've got one of my men on duty there right now.
But you have a home?
Done if you hadn't come by. The police have been here all afternoon questioning me about what happened last night.
I know. I got a call to come see Marco myself.
Oh.
Why don't you come with me?
No, I'll be all right. What does the lieutenant want to see you about?
You just said it was important.
Well, it's all my fault. If I hadn't gone out to see if Hester was hiding somewhere
it's
outside.
It's not your fault. How could you know? The cat, or whatever it was, must have followed her to the shop.
No cat hypnotizes and kills.
That's right. No ordinary cat. Take it easy. It's only a harmless alley cat.
Why don't you just go away somewhere?
Why?
It doesn't matter where, just anywhere. All of these murders and now Hester. I'm just so frightened.
Come on.
Inside the lining of Hester's cape. Take a closer look. Is it genuine?
Offhand, I'd say this comes from the period around 450 BC, the time that the temples of Bast were being destroyed.
Now, how about the inscription? Does it say anything about the mummy?
I have to study these hieroglyphs before I can decipher them. I need my research sources.
What does that mean?
Well, if you let me take this to the university, I can look at the references there for my translation.
I don't think so.
But if it's important, we'll know exactly what it says. Just give me a chance.
Well, how much time do you need?
A couple of hours.
Okay, Roger. I'll trust you. It's 8 now. I'll give you until 12.
Thank you.
does the lot. I think you've got everything you need for your translation.
I don't know how to thank you, Dr. Reinhardt. What with opening up a library at this hour and finding all this material.
Stolen jewels, blood-drinking cats. After listening to that story of yours, how could I possibly refuse?
But you don't believe me.
I didn't say that. Do you mind if I have a look at that amulet?
Oh, yes, of course, right here. There.
That's odd. That's very odd.
Well, what's that?
Well, as you and I both know, in Egyptian art, bast is always portrayed in one of two ways, either as a cat with a human body or a complete cat figure. This is just a cat's head. Does this strike you as being peculiar?
Yes, it does, now that you mention it.
The head without a body cannot move. This heavy chain. What does that suggest to you?
A prisoner?
Exactly. You know, this amulet was never used for the worship of Bast. It was made for another purpose. To hold something captive.
You're saying that this amulet was placed around the mummy's neck to keep it from coming back to life again?
The followers of Bast could turn themselves into cats. Gain immortality by drinking human blood.
Oh, yes, I know that legend.
Vampires turning to bats in the wilds of Transylvania. Man assuming the shape of wolves in Germany. Of foxes in China. In Africa, men turn into leopards. The Arctic Eskimos believe that their wizards are transformed into bears.
More legends.
Maybe. But why is it that since the beginning of time, people of every culture, living 10,000 miles apart with no possible connection, have always held the same belief that in certain conditions, man can take the form of an animal? You know, behind every universal legend lies a universal reality.
It's easier for me to believe in a human murderer, somebody who's trained an animal to kill.
Well, maybe you'll find the answer when you've deciphered that inscription. But if you don't mind, while you're working, I'll go back to the library. I think I can locate another treatise on the Bast cult in an English translation.
Well, don't you read hieroglyphics, Doctor?
Oh, I'm just a librarian.
But surely with your knowledge, I was under the impression that you traveled extensively in the East.
My dear boy, the farthest East I've ever been is Pasadena. Enjoy yourself.
Hello. Yes, Lieutenant.
Are you doing any good with that translation?
I'm almost finished. Just give me another hour or so.
Good. I've dug up an answer on my own.
Answer to what?
I should have known right from the beginning. But you threw me a curve with that cat routine.
There was a cat.
Well, right now I'm interested in human beings. There are only two people who knew what we did. One was Hester, and she's dead. The other is Rena.
Rena?
I've been running a check on Miss Rena Carter. Or trying to. There's no record of her anywhere. Not a trace. She just shows up out of nowhere.
We feed her all the necessary information. We talk about the thief. We talked about Hester. She knew just where to go and what to do.
But it doesn't make sense.
I'm picking her up right now. Maybe she'll
give us that answer. Now you hold on to that amulet, pal.
This is a camera you've never seen before. It's called Snapshot. It takes 16 big, beautiful color prints on one roll of film. With Snapshot, you never have to load or unload film. Snapshot is already loaded with color film. It's easy. All you do is aim and shoot. Snapshot is just $9.95,
And after you take your pictures, you just mail your camera to Snapshot. We pay the postage. And when you receive your prints and negatives, we'll also send you a brand new camera already loaded with color film for the additional cost of the prints alone.
Snapshot. Lightweight. Snapshot. Practically indestructible. Snapshot. With built-in Magic Cube adapter. Snapshot.
To get your Snapshot camera and film, send just $9.95 to Snapshot, Columbia, Mississippi, 39429. Or call this toll-free number, 1-800-327-2775, and use your Visa or MasterCharge. You'll get your camera in 1 week with safe delivery guaranteed.
It's a warehouse clearance sale, and we need your help. McTavish Sells is overstocked on all its rental return and new furniture items, and we have to clear them out fast, which means huge savings to you. Sofas are going for a low $99, chairs for $39, four-drawer chests are selling for only $27, lamps at just $9, dozens of dinettes, and they start at only $49 for all five pieces. Get to McTavish Sells now for the best selection during this giant warehouse clearance sale. McTavish Sells Furniture.
Yelp Meetings is the finest place where everyone may go to get the food and atmosphere of friendly Mexico. Tamales and tortillas are among the favorites here. The guacamole salad and the carta blanca beer. Tostadas, enchiladas, and the tacos, meat and cheese. And all the other dishes that are cooked and served to please. Yelp Phoenix, Yelp Phoenix.
At McDavid Pontiac, it's a whole new decade calling for dramatically new kinds of American cars.
Cars that are trim, cars that are roomy, cars that are efficient, cars that are designed to last.
That car is the new 1980 Pontiac. At McDavid Pontiac, you'll find exciting new performance.
For 1980, you get more Pontiac excitement to the gallon.
Bill McDavid Pontiac Honda, West 7th and Fort Worth.
David McDavid Pontiac Honda, Airport Freeway, Irving. Right wide track.
Roger.
Yes, Doctor. Did you find what you're looking for?
Found more than I was looking for. Here's something you must see. Wait a minute. Have you finished your translation yet?
Yes, I just did.
Was there a phrase on that amulet that translates Korup Set?
That's right, there was.
Do you know the meaning of that phrase?
Well, I was puzzled by it. Generally, it refers to something that's hidden away. Something secret that's guarded by Set, the god of the underworld. But I don't know exactly what it means. It
means that I was right about the purpose of that amulet. Here, look at this. Beware the seal of Korupset, for he who dares to remove it will open the gates of hell. There's your exact translation. Good night, Roger.
Thank you.
sure I'd almost given you up.
What happened to the lights?
I left them off, hoping the cats would go away. They've been prowling around here all night.
Cats? What cats?
Roger, we've got to get out of here.
Lieutenant Marker's on his way here to arrest you.
What?
Don't you see? Everything about you adds to Marco's suspicions. No previous address, no social security number. A girl who covers the tracks. A girl who stopped at the shop not by accident, but with deliberate purpose. Marco thinks that you destroyed everyone who stood between you and that amulet.
I know that's impossible. They were killed by a cat.
I know they were. It's written on the amulet.
You found it?
Yes. That amulet is placed on the mummy's throat for the same reason a stake is driven through a vampire's heart, to keep it from rising and resuming an unnatural life, nourished by blood.
So, when the thief removed the amulet, the mummy revived?
That's right. Vampires seek their prey in the form of bats. The follower of bats took the shape of a cat to kill for blood and track down that amulet. And once that amulet is destroyed, this creature can live forever.
So then, cat creature is really the mummy of the High Priest of Bast?
No, Reyna. Not a priest. The inscription on the amulet identifies the mummy as a priestess. No wonder you're afraid of cats. They recognize you for what you are. The priestess of Bast.
No, you don't know what you're saying.
Of course you have no past history. All you know of today's world is what you drained from the mind of Hester's clerk when you hypnotized her and sent her to death.
How can they make you understand? You don't know what it's like to be buried away alone in the darkness. Century upon century of blackness. Paralyzed, unable to move. Breathe, yet conscious of every crawling moment. And when I revived, I had to protect myself, to get to anyone who might have that amulet, and that was self-preservation, not murder.
Whatever it was, those people are dead.
But I'm alive. Don't you see what that means? To be able to see and touch and love, to feel joy and desire. I meant it when I said we could go away together. We can be together always. That'll be my gift to you, the secret of immortality.
You're asking me to become what you are, to kill for blood.
I'm offering you eternal life.
No, no. What you offer is eternal death.
I won't let you go!
Thank you.
If you've enjoyed tonight's features, join us Monday for Indian Love Call and Whistling in Dixie. More feature entertainment from 11.
There's comedy Sunday night on 11. The members of the WJM news team are happily anticipating the results of the news awards presentation, all except for Murray, who has never won an award and doesn't expect to this year, on the Mary Tyler Moore Show, Sunday night at 10. Then at 10:30, Bob tries to withdraw from a tennis tournament when he discovers that Emily will be his doubles partner, and he's afraid of losing on The Bob Newhart Show. Mary Tyler Moore and Bob Newhart. Great comedy, Sunday night on 11.
Sleep Country, Dallas' largest retailer of mattresses, announces a gigantic special factory purchase of discontinued 1979 models. Over 2,000 famous mattress and box springs now sale price just $69.95 each piece for twin, full, queen, and king. Choose from Simmons, Sealy, Restonic, and Spring Air. Choose from Firm, Extra Firm, Posture Firm, and Luxury Firm. Sleep Country, quality merchandise, unbeatable prices. That's what makes us different. On Midway north of LBJ, in Garland at LBJ in Centerville, and Arlington next to Six Flags Mall.
Hi, I'm Tom Delvin, owner of the Renter Center. You know, today with inflation squeezing your take-home dollar, inexpensive entertainment makes sense, particularly if you can't afford to overextend your credit. We're trying to help keep your budget balanced, so we've kept rental payments on our color televisions, stereos, and appliances as low as possible. You can get top name brand merchandise, there's no charge for service, and what's more, you're under no obligation. Make the Renter Center your entertainment center, and you'll find it easy and economical.
Hello, my name is Pat Carr. I'd like to take this time to wish all of you at home a very happy holiday season from all of us here at Channel.
It's a chemical defoliant known as Agent Orange, and hundreds of Vietnam veterans believe that exposure to it has caused serious health problems for them and their families. Their case got a big boost late last month when a federal judge ruled that veterans could bring suit in federal court against the manufacturers of the herbicide. Over 10 million gallons of Agent Orange were sprayed in Vietnam, according to a recent General Accounting Office report, and thousands more Americans were exposed than the Defense Department originally claimed. Many families say their children are also victims, like 8-year-old Carrie Ryan.
Didn't she give you the eye?
Carrie was born 8 years ago with 18 birth defects.
Did myself?
Affecting every major organ in her body. I'm convinced that it was Agent Orange.
When they drafted me, they genetically drafted her and exposed her to the Agent Orange. All her birth defects are a direct result of my service in Vietnam. Therefore, she is a Vietnam veteran and entitled to Vietnam veterans benefits.
Michael Ryan suffers the hearing loss, skin rashes, and headaches that are common complaints among vets who are exposed. Yet it took Maureen Ryan 6 years to link Michael's health problems and Carrie's birth defects with Agent Orange.
I was angry at what they had put her through. I was angry the 8 years they had taken from us. I was angry over always working and never having any money because you're paying medical bills. And I realized that I had decided at that point, it took me about 4 or 5 days, wondering if I was going to be able to live with this. Wondering, what do you do with all this anger now?
The answer became clear when the Ryans heard about a Long Island attorney who was initiating a class action suit for veterans exposed to Agent Orange. They're now part of the suit along with 361 other vets and their children.
These veterans went to Vietnam shoulder to shoulder as a group, and the chemical companies would have them come home and one at a time try and take on each individual multinational conglomerate chemical company in some local court. What we've done by asking the court to treat them as what they are, the class of all the veterans who served in Vietnam, is combine their cases. We don't know yet whether or not these children will have problems with their children. Who's going to pay for them? The taxpayers or the profiteers?
I want an explanation. I think my daughter is owed an explanation. I want them to explain to her why she's not on a bicycle and in a wheelchair. I want to see that the VA comes forward and gives her the VA benefits that are due her, that are due any veteran. I want to see the chemical companies provide for her for the rest of her life.
If successful, the suit will require the five chemical companies named to set aside a portion of their profits for medical aid. It would also ban manufacture of Agent Orange, which is still used as an herbicide in several states. I'm Neela Smith for Today's Woman.
Night Watch News, an encore presentation of the 10 p.m. news recorded earlier tonight for viewing in this time period.
Good evening and thank you for joining us. A routine dumpster fire in Dallas has resulted in a bizarre homicide. Firefighters responded early this morning to a trash fire call and discovered the body of a young boy. 11's Hank Irwin has details.
Dallas police were called to the scene of a routine dumpster fire during the night behind a sporting goods store along Northwest Highway. The reason, the discovery of a badly burned body of a young boy located inside the dumpster. Police spokesman Officer Bob Worth said the development tied together an earlier neighborhood search for a missing youngster.
Extinguishing the fire found the remains of a badly burned child which the medical examiner estimated at 7 to 12 years old, approximately 3 feet 8 inches tall, maybe 50 or 60 pounds. This answers basically the description of the missing child.
The county medical examiner has tentatively identified the body as that of Steve Little. However, positive identification is still pending. The cause of death is listed as strangulation, and that means homicide. Captain W.F. Gentry of the Crimes Against Persons Division says his men have made that case a top priority since the discovery of the body, with detectives combing the neighborhood searching for details. He says this type of crime simply makes him plain mad.
It's hard for me to believe that anyone could take any kind of child out and just destroy him for apparently no worthwhile reason. Selfish motive.
Gentry says in his 20 years with the force, he has never seen anything worse than this, but the galling element in the case is the lack of leads whatsoever, and he requests anyone with any information to call the Dallas Police Department immediately. Hank Irwin, Metroplex News.
And tonight, Fort Worth police are continuing to investigate a double murder which took place early today on the city's south side. Fort Worth police found 25-year-old Sylvia Humphreys and her husband, 32-year-old W.D. Humphreys, dead in the bedroom of their apartment at the Pilgrim Valley Manor Apartments, 1701 East Roberts. Mrs. Humphreys' 8-year-old son, Syria Wagner, was asleep in another bedroom, unaware that his mother and stepfather had been killed. Police were called to the apartment by the dead woman's mother, who had been unable to reach her daughter by telephone. Mrs. Humphreys was found face down on the floor in the bedroom with a gunshot to the head. Her husband was found in the bed with a gunshot in the left arm and the back of the head. Police are looking for a 40-year-old suspect who is out on a $6,000 bond in connection with another slaying, the December 10th beating death of Francisco Arredondo. A witness told police officers he saw the suspect going up the stairs to the Humphreys apartment armed with a .45 caliber pistol and shotgun. Fort Worth police have issued an all-points bulletin for the suspect, identified as A.D. Randall. He is considered armed and dangerous. He was last seen driving a 1978 red and white Buick.
The United States and Iran have found something to agree about. Both countries have blamed the Soviet Union for the bloody coup in Afghanistan. President Carter says the gross interference by the Soviets in Afghanistan's coup was a blatant violation of international rules. And he says that the United States plans urgent consultations with allies to see how the world community might respond. Meanwhile, Iran's ruling Revolutionary Council has issued a protest saying the Soviet involvement is regarded as a hostile action against all the Muslim world. Islamic militants in Afghanistan have vowed to intensify their war against the Soviet troops.
Iran's foreign minister says that as long as the U.S. presses for international economic sanctions on Iran, there won't be the, in his words, slightest change regarding the American hostages. Sadek Gotsbada told this to Western European ambassadors tonight, and he again threatened spy trials for the hostages if sanctions are imposed. Meanwhile, President Carter has expressed confidence that the 15-member U.N. Security Council will approve those sanctions. The president is dispatching Secretary of State Vance to the U.N. tomorrow to press for the American case. Four OPEC members have announced oil price hikes of up to 20%. Industry sources say Libya will raise its crude oil price by nearly $5 a barrel. Those increases are expected to add 3 cents to the cost of a gallon of gasoline and heating oil.
The Department of Energy has ruled that the nation's service stations can dip into their January gasoline allotments to ease them through the New Year's holiday travel load. Well, here in the Metroplex, as well as the entire state, the situation looks pretty good for the motorist if he can afford it. That word today from the Dallas area AAA Auto Club. Motorists can expect to find about 80% of the stations open on New Year's Day. That's according to the AAA, with slightly higher prices posted than before Christmas. A spokesman, Robert Beams, adds more details of what to expect.
Our prices have gone up. We find that the average price of self-service here in the Dallas area is now about 99.2 cents. Premium is $1.04.3, and unleaded gas is running about $1.03.4.
Brem says motorists can expect the normal operation of service stations during the weekend, with stations closing around 6 p.m. on Saturday and about 50% open on Sunday. The AAA highly suggests filling up the tank in the morning and keeping to the 55-mile-per-hour speed limit. We will take a break here and be back with more on the Metroplex News in just a moment. Stay with us.
Was this you last night, tossing and turning, pillow propping and punching your way into a comfortable position, trying to sit up and relax or sleep? Your flatbed was just not made to fit the natural curves of your body. This could be why you're uncomfortable. Now there's a bed that automatically adjusts to fit your body's contour. It's the famous Craftmatic adjustable bed. Just press this button and automatically raise your head and back, raise your legs, or both. Enjoy sound sleep, watch TV, read, or just relax. Craftmatic helps to reduce neck, back, and leg strain your flatbed can cause. Craftmatic helps promote improved circulation and can help to relieve tension and fatigue. Available with a gentle, soothing massage in all mattress sizes. Call now for this colorful free booklet describing Craftmatic adjustable bed. Call toll-free 1-800-228-2210. No obligation. 1-800-228-2210. Operators on duty right now. 1-800-228-2210.
Country music's top 20. Available only at Safeway.
And we will sail away. Blue sky smiling at me. It's a cheating situation. She's pulling me back.
Top hits by the original artist, just $7.99 for record or tape, only at Safeway.
Here is your chance to stop paying rent at Big B and Lone Star. Own your own home with three bedrooms, two baths, 1,064 square feet, completely furnished, installed on your lot for only $15,991. Money available, VA, FHA, conventional financing. We offer Coleman energy efficient heating and air conditioning. See our homes, compare our prices. Big B Mobile Homes, Fort Worth and Cleburne, Lone Star Manufactured Housing, Dallas and Carrollton.
The Western Union Telegraph office in downtown Fort Worth was a bustling place this afternoon. A party was in full swing. However, the celebration held a hint of sadness as two employees bid farewell to over 50 years of service with Western Union. The retirement party honored 64-year-old Morgan Bronner of Fort Worth and 57-year-old John Ferris of Weatherford. Both men went to work for Western Union during the Depression, and at that time, if they were lucky, they made $8 to $10 a week delivering messages. At one time, it only cost 30 cents to send a 10-word telegram 150 miles. The highest rate was $3 to $5, and those high-priced versions were from coast to coast. Both men have fond memories of riding bicycles and delivering telegrams, but there were also bad times when they were called on to deliver death messages during World War II.
Some of the women would pass out on you, and you'd always like to get a neighbor or something to go with you if you knew it was a death message during the war and all, because they could go into hysterics and they'd read the telegram, so you always stayed with them until after they had read it and got settled down. A lot of times you'd have to go get the neighbors to help you with them.
Western Union District Manager Bob Holtzman says in his 32 years of employment at the company, he has heard only compliments, never ever criticism about the two retirees. And with that record, what more need be said?
Well, the countdown to the Cotton Bowl continued today as Houston's coach Bill Yeoman and Nebraska's Tom Osborne faced the press and talked about their teams. Both coaches offered praise and respect about their opponents. Osborne said Houston reminds him of the very tough Missouri squad, while Cougar coach Bill Yeoman claims Nebraska's defensive tackles can bench press his entire team. Well, all kidding aside, both coaches agreed this year's Cotton Bowl will be a significant game.
Trying to win the conference or represent the conference in the Cotton Bowl. And we feel that there is a substantial responsibility involved there. And as a result of that, we think it's a terribly important football game.
I'd say the same. We're not Big Eight champions, and that takes a little off to representing a conference, I guess. But
You know, I'm always amazed when people say, well, you know, are you guys just kind of approaching this as a coming down here and having a good time reward for a good season? And, you know, it doesn't really mean anything because you're not going to win the national championship. But, hey, you know, if you're involved in this business and if you're competitors, if you're 1-10, you know, that next game's important. It's got to be.
Well, Yeoman says he hasn't quite got a grasp on the Cougars' potential this year. At times he feels they're enthusiastic, but on some occasions they have looked flat. Still, they keep on winning. Osborne, on the other hand, says the Huskers have played consistently throughout the year, except for a subpar performance against rival Oklahoma. Both coaches expect the game next Tuesday to hinge on field position and the defense. The Cotton Bowl Classic is set for 1 p.m. kickoff in Dallas.
Well, authorities say a natural gas well that blew out near the panhandle community of Briscoe could be capped by tomorrow. The blowout forced at least 95 families to flee from poisonous fumes last night. Three fired Houston policemen have begun serving their year and a day prison term at a minimum security facility in Alabama. The trio was convicted of civil rights violations in the 1977 death of Mexican-American Jose Campos Torres. Well, Howard says most of the rain is over. He'll tell you all about it next.
Tonight, 2,739 teenage girls will become pregnant. A teenage pregnancy affects the entire family. It erupts education, and the chances of pregnancy complications are doubled. Write Family Planning, Box 2225, Rockville, Maryland 20852, for a free booklet that'll help you avoid the hassles and risks of the 2,739 teenage pregnancies that'll begin tonight.
This is Don Wallace of the Wallace Wildlife Show, seen each week at 1 o'clock on KTVT, Fort Worth, Dallas. We have exciting fishing and hunting adventures, freshwater and saltwater, Mexico films, Canadian films, as well as films from around the entire southwestern United States. I hope you'll join me every Sunday at 1 o'clock for all of this fishing and hunting adventure right here on KTVT, Fort Worth, Dallas, Channel 11.
You know what I think? I think you forgot to lock your door. It's a funny thing. A lot of people do that. They forget. That's too bad, because all crime needs is a chance. Don't give it the chance. Light up your doors. Lights make burglars nervous. And make your windows secure. Say, I understand you're going to Peoria next week. While you're gone, have a neighbor keep an eye on your house. You know, pick up your mail, keep the place looking lived in, and use a timer to turn lights on and off. Hey, fudge brownies. And me on a diet. Oh, you don't know me, see. It's my job to teach you to protect yourselves. Make it your job to learn. Write to Box 6600, Rockville, Maryland. And one more thing. Lock your doors. That's an easy way to, take a bite out of crime.
Most of the thick clouds have pushed down to the east of Fort Worth and Dallas. Rains were quite spotty through the area. They reported at Stephenville 1 in 1,800 of an inch of rain, but Dallas reported only 0.04 of an inch of rain. So you can see how it really differed through the area. We need the rain. I think a lot of people had about, half to 0.75 of an inch. Current reading at Abilene is 44. Cloudy out there, but the only sign of rain is off to the east of us. Tyler's reporting rain, getting heavy thunderstorms down around San Antonio and Victoria area. They reported on the north side of San Antonio over 2.5 inches of rain. Still raining down there, so a little local flooding through that section. Farther north, the rain turns into snow up and through Colorado. Of course, the high country, the ski country, had a tremendous amount of snow. But even out in the plains, they're getting snow extending east through Nebraska over into Iowa at the present time. Omaha, snow and 30 degrees. Up in Bismarck, dirt, 20 degrees up there. And in the Pacific Northwest, another storm moving in, but not too much weather associated so far with this particular system. San Francisco, 46, and down in Southern California, Los Angeles, 59 degrees. On the eastern seaboard, relatively fair skies, 38 up at Albany. Detroit is reporting 30, and down at Atlanta, 46 degrees. Looking now at that Texas weather map, temperature at the airport, Dallas-Fort Worth, 50 degrees at the present time. Fairly mild under cloudy, foggy skies. The thunderstorms are off to the south, and they're moving in an easterly direction. To the north, Oklahoma City is reporting 44. few of the other rainfall reports. Wichita Falls reported 1 in 700, so that's a good rain. Abilene, over an inch there. San Angelo, 1 in 400 of an inch. And Austin, 3,100. Mineral Wells, a good rain, 8,400. And Waco, 85. So we did have pretty good rain through the region. Looks like the front will continue moving east. Our winds will be light northerly, but most of this cloud shield is off to the east, or at least the thick part. Checking now on our current temperature, 50 degrees. Relative humidity, still high. Kind of a foggy, cool night, 88. Winds are north of 7. Pressure reads 30 and 26 hundredths. We recorded 64 hundredths of an inch of rain. The forecast for Saturday, cloudy with occasional light rain through mid-morning, more of a drizzle, then slowly decreasing cloudiness by evening. Winds will be north of 10, low 45. High tomorrow, chilly, 49. Sunday, we're expecting partly cloudy, we should say partly sunny, continued cool, winds north, 31 in the morning, freezing. High in the afternoon, 47. That's your weather.
It's kind of a dreary weekend. It's way it's shaping
it's,
up.
Well, it's going to get better.
Okay.
It's going to be real good New Year's. I'm figuring partly cloudy and mild New Year's.
So the Cotton Bowl should be a little bit better than
right,
last year.
Right.
Okay. Thank you, Howard. That is our news tonight. Enjoy the weekend and drive safe over the holiday period. We'll see you, or I won't see you, but Vicki and Hank will see you Sunday night at 10. Good night.
Good night.
This has been Night Watch News, an encore presentation of the 10 p.m. news recorded earlier tonight.
And now, moments of meditation.
It is said that the Christmas season is the loneliest time of the year for some people. As we make preparations and plans for how we will celebrate this special holiday, let us keep in mind those of our acquaintance who might need our special remembrance. When Jesus taught, he often spoke in parables. If he were speaking to us today, he might speak to us about the parable of skyscrapers, freeways, or even balloons. And I would like to share with you a parable of the balloon. Everyone was happy at the birthday party except one little boy. He had all the usual problems that shy little guys have. He wanted to have fun just like everyone else, but something inside of him always just got tied up. He could never really bring himself to reach out to others. So even the times that should have been the happiest were lonely times for him. He wanted to reach out and be a part of things, but he just didn't know how. One of the other boys picked up a balloon and tapped it to one of his friends. But balloons don't always go where they are tapped. The wind took the balloon on its way until it touched the shoulder of the shy little guy. He didn't know that the balloon wasn't meant for him, and for the first time in his life, he felt like he was part of the party. And he really thought that someone had tapped the balloon to him. He took the balloon, and with great excitement, he tapped it back. Soon he was playing with others. A balloon that really wasn't meant for him somehow meant so very much to him. God's blessings are like that, and we have the power to bring God's blessings to others. Sometimes we tap a blessing to a friend and it never reaches them. He never knows we sent it. And yet by the wind of the Spirit, God may send our blessings to someone we didn't.
This is KTVT, telecasting in color with studios in Dallas and Fort Worth, operating on an assigned frequency of Channel 11, as authorized by the Federal Communications Commission, Washington, D.C. Transmitter location, Cedar Hill, 16 miles southwest of Dallas, with a maximum power of 316,000 watts. Portions of today's programs were mechanically reproduced. Programs produced by KTVT are under copyright, and any use, reproduction, or rebroadcast of such programs is forbidden without the expressed written consent of KTVT. Until tomorrow morning, on behalf of the management and staff of Channel 11, good night.